Last time, I told you that a page is the mapping between the pointer and the physical RAM. Pages have their own flags. Those can be read, write or execute, for example. For your PC, your data is just numbers, so you could execute some code where there is just random data, not code. This is where pages come in handy. If that page doesn't have the execute flag, the CPU will detect that and raise a page fault signal. To allocate memory, you have to call virtual alloc. There are also some other versions of this function, but we don't care about those. You have to understand that this function has a different purpose from the new or malloc in C and C++. Virtual alloc will allocate pages for you, and hence the minimum allocation size is the page size, which is rather large. So if you pass a smaller size, it will just be rounded up to the page's size. For allocating smaller random things, there is another Windows function called heapalloc. Basically, all new or malloc do is call virtual alloc at some point, and then have a data structure to manage the memory and give it to the user. I might talk about implementing your own memory allocator in the future. Coding time. Calling getSystemInfo will give us various information, including the page size. I also made a roundup function that will round up any number to be a multiple of the page size. The first thing we do is call virtual alloc. Notice that you can specify at what memory location to allocate the memory if you want. But this will fail if that memory region is already used. Also, that memory region will be rounded down to the page size. Next, we pass how many bytes to allocate. But remember that this number will be rounded up to be a multiple of a page size. Then we pass the memreserve and memcommit parameters. Memreserve will just tell Windows to keep in mind that we need those pages, but they will not be mapped into RAM until you call memcommit. In this case, we both reserve and commit at the same time, but you can do some powerful things with these pages. For example, in this video, I created a vector data structure that grows without having to reallocate the memory by first reserving a lot of memory and then committing it. Okay, now we write to that memory and read it back. Remember that the size will be rounded to be a multiple of a page size, and on my machine, a page size is 4096 bytes. So that is why we can access a bigger memory location than specified. Let's run it. You can see what my page size is, you can also see the roundup function working, and finally, you can see that the allocated memory is working properly. To deallocate the memory, you have to call virtual free. Finally, I have one more thing to show you, and it is the virtual protect function that will change the last flag from the virtual alloc function. Again, you should look on your own at these flags, because there are some interesting things here. But for now, we will change the protection of these pages from read-write to no access. Any attempt to access this page will crash the program. Why would you want to do that? Well, during development, instead of freeing the memory, you can mark it as having no access, allowing you to catch some potential bugs. If you access freed memory, it is technically possible to not always have your program crash. So, by making it as no access, you can be sure that any access to it will crash the program. There is also a page guard option, but for this one, it won't crash your program. You have to catch its error signal, and I haven't personally looked much into it. Okay, your homework for today is to play with these new functions and parameters and read the documentation to see how they work. Not very interesting, I know, but now we will be reading another process's memory. See you in the next video.